Hello everyone, welcome to the third episode of this series, The Era of VTuber, Building One with Python and Unity. The last episode we have been going through about how to establish the TCP connection as well building the sample 3D project for 3D avatar. So in this episode, we will be going through the procedures of deploying a Live2D model in Unity, and as well as some code review about the controller script. So let's get started. Right now, we'll dive into the setup of building the Unity project first, and then we'll do the code review later. So like in the previous episode, we will create a new Unity project. And we'll click the 3D one, and we'll name the project as the Live2D Avatar Tutorial. Any name is okay. And so while waiting for the project to be created, we can download the Live2D SDK for Unity from its official website here. We can change the language to English first. Then we'll go to the downloads and Cubism SDK. Then we'll scroll down a bit and we'll find Cubism SDK for Unity. Click the download one and consent to the software license agreement and download the latest version right here. And so you store it in whatever position you like, and I've downloaded it already. So here the SS, I've downloaded it already, so I won't download it again. And you download it. And so we'll import the SDK later after the creation of the new Unity project. So wait a bit. Okay, so you see the Unity project has been created, and we'll click in the project window, click import package, custom package, and we'll import the Cubism SDK for Unity here. So just import all will be okay. So while importing, we'll be downloading a Live2D model from the Live2D website here as well. We'll go back to the main page here first. The Live2D has provided some official sample data and some Live2D model here as well. So here I will use the Heroic Momos model, and it looks pretty. Yes, and you can download other here, like here the sample data. And there are some precautions here, and you scroll it down and you can choose other, but like here the wish or the okay, so you go through here the Heroic Momos, and you download the pro version and you save it wherever you like, and you unzip it. So I've downloaded it already, so I will download it again. You save it and unzip it, and you unzip and drag all the contents into the Unity project inspector. After finish importing, you can see a Live2D folder which store all the SDKs and some sample projects here. So we'll just drag the folder, the full version here, and drag it. And so you can download others, like you download Miku's one, but you may have to change the controller script a bit to suit its parameters. So you see in the Heroic folder, you click into the runtime and you'll find the prefab and drag it into the main scene. But here you can't see the model and in the game as well, because you have to run it first to load all the mesh files here. Okay, so now you can see the Live2D here. Okay, so however, it got some projection problems, I think, as the eyes and the ears can't show it properly in here. As well as in game here, I'll change the layout a bit first. So like in the previous video, we can change the camera setting first. So we change it to solid color first, change it to green, and change the position of the camera. So made a bit. Okay, like here, change the aspect ratio as well. So to fix the projection problem here, you can change the projection from perspective to orthographic here. And you change the size here to something like near. And you can see the projection error has been solved and all of the components of the Live2D model has been displaced on the game window perfectly. At last, we'll import all the script from the GitHub to the Unity project. We'll go to the scripts and Live2D here, and here we can create a folder named scripts to store all the scripts and select all and drag it to the Unity here. And then you drag the controller script onto the Unity prefab. And so you can see there are some different parameters that you can be adjusted here as well as on the controller script. For example, you can change the threshold here as well. And there is nothing that you should disable. Just keep it all enabled here will be enough. So you can change all some of the parameters here. And that's it. And at last you press the run button here and you can save the scenes. So that's it. We have finished the setting and let's jump to the code review here. Right, so in the heroic controller, you have to indeed visualize the TCP connection as well as in the Unity Chan controller. So these are the same, but the difference is it gives you more freedom or more options to control the Unity Chan controller. Like you control the eye aspect ratio of the individual eyes as well as the iris here as well. So just pair the variable in the send string to the corresponding variables added in your script. And for the Live2D model, you have to import the Live2D cubism core and the framework library here. Okay, so in order to apply those values to the Live2D model, we'll jump to the late update version as suggested by the documentation of the Live2D here. So for later versions of cubism SDK, is suggested to use the late update here so that you can override the original animation. And you have to declare the cubism model here first and find the cubism model. And you attach the late update here as well. And so the parameters of the model is zero based and is shown here. It's shown in the heroic model and parameters. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and they are stored in an array. So you select the right one and with the right index and to apply here. Here I will using the clamp function as well in the Unity because of the limit of the parameters. So like for the first one, it is limited from negative 30 to 30 and we clamp this value here. So the other one is some kind of similar to the 3D project. And so that's a wrap and this is the end of this episode. It's just a relatively short one compared to the 3D one because there's no need to explain the TC concept once again if there is another episode about it. So make sure you check the GitHub page for the Unity sample project as well as other script here. And in the next episode, we'll be talking about the detection of other facial expressions like the blinking one, the iris tracking, and the mouth movement. So if you enjoyed this video, please give this video a thumbs up and share this video to your friends as well. And I'll catch you later in the next episode, the last episode, I think. So thanks for watching here as well.